Hi, I'm Antonio Mora. Salt is a hypertension-causing monster. You should eat white meat instead of red meat to control cholesterol. Coffee is bad for your arteries and can cause cancer. You're gaining weight because of fats, not carbs. And you gotta take 10,000 steps a day to live a longer life. Hold on. Studies have now found that none of that is accurate, even though most people would swear they are medical truths. You can't blame them. I used to believe all of it myself, because medical studies and health experts that got lots of publicity on TV and in newspapers told me so. How many of you reduced your salt intake to control your blood pressure? For decades, the fact that high sodium diets caused hypertension was as certain as death and taxes. Now, two major studies are saying not so fast. They found that for most of us, sodium intake makes little difference when it comes to our blood pressure. Turns out that it only seems to make a difference on the extremes. Those who have very high or very low sodium diets have a higher risk of heart disease. It really doesn't affect the rest of us. In fact, one study found that the participants who consumed under 2,500 milligrams of sodium each day had higher blood pressure than those who consumed higher quantities of sodium. A new study, albeit a small one, finds that giving up red meat for white meat isn't going to do anything to lower your cholesterol. One caveat, other effects from eating red meat could make it worse for your heart than white meat, but cholesterol levels were identical. How often have you been told that coffee is bad for your heart and can cause cancer? In 2018, a California court went as far as ordering coffee companies to put cancer warnings on their beverages. Now, California has seen the light and passed a regulation that recognizes the scientific consensus that coffee isn't hazardous to your health and, hey, might even be good for you. I don't know about you, but I'm especially annoyed by friends with those Fitbits or other pedometers who like to preach about how we need to take 10,000 steps a day to live longer lives. It's certainly good for you, but studies now find benefits decline after 7,500 steps, and 4,400 steps are enough to lower death rates for older women. One A Day and Centrum are brands that are household names, but did you know that recent studies show multivitamins don't reduce the risk for heart disease, cancer, cognitive decline, or early death? But that isn't stopping us. 70% of Americans over 60 take daily vitamin supplements. And don't get me started on conventional wisdom that has led to medical myths without scientific studies to back them. 8 glasses of water a day? Not necessary. Take a look at this graphic from Vox that looks at common foods and drinks. It is appropriately titled, Everything We Eat Both Causes and Prevents Cancer. The dots on the left of the vertical line show studies that claim something protects against cancer. The ones on the right show studies that claim the same thing causes cancer. As you can see, for every single item, there are studies that say both. I'm still hoping for research that says refined sugar is good for you. I haven't found that one yet. Of course, the worst case scenario is when researchers falsify data or spin it to support their thesis, and that leads people to make decisions that are harmful. The debunked claim that vaccines caused autism has led to the resurgence of measles. John Ioannidis, professor of medicine at Stanford University, specializes in the study of scientific studies and authored a widely cited article titled Why Most Published Research Findings Are False. He claims the majority of papers that get published, even in serious journals, are pretty sloppy. In fact, one analysis found 30% of findings published in the world's highest quality medical journals were later found to be wrong or exaggerated. That's among the top randomized controlled trials. 5 out of 6 articles on non-randomized trials were later found to have issues. Combine that with the fact that studies on lifestyle choices, diet, and exercise are the ones that are most likely, that you are most likely to see on your local news or in newspapers, and those topics are the ones that are most often wrong. Making things worse, a study found journalists rarely inform the public when initial studies are disconfirmed. Before concluding, I have to admit that everything I've just told you is based on scientific studies. Given how often they're wrong, I could be wrong too. So avoid making immediate decisions based on any study trumpeted by the media. The best advice is to take everything with a grain of salt and to talk to your doctor.